worthy of our praise. Now, if you'll listen to this one, and if I can find it real quick. I got about three of them. I tune it regularly, so. But it's called He Didn't Come Down. While you're turning to Acts 26, I just want to bring this to you. And this is why we have eternal life. Often I stop to think just where I'd be had Jesus come down from that cruel tree. There'd be no hope for man, no peace could be found. Praise God, I am glad that He didn't come down. He didn't come down, oh no, He didn't come down. 10,000 angels were kept all around. He could have called them to set Him free, but He stayed on the cross for you and for me. Picture His mother there with tears in her eyes as they mocked and scorned Him and pierced His side. They said, if you be King, then come to the ground. But He prayed, forgive them. He didn't come down, oh no, He didn't come down. 10,000 angels were camped all around. He could have called them to set Him free, but He stayed on the cross today. Because of an old rugged cross, He died. But glory to God, I don't like to leave Him on the cross because that's not where He is. They laid Him in a lowly tomb, but you know what today, church? He's not there either. But glory to God, on that third glorious day, the stone was rolled away, not to let Jesus out, but to let us in. For He was risen. What did the angel say? He said, why seek ye the living among the dead? Today, church, we're not serving a dead God, but we're serving a living God. We're serving a God who loves each and every one of us as individuals, collectively, but He loved the whole world. If you have your Bibles, if you'll turn to Acts in the 26th chapter, in the 24th verse, Acts 26 and 24. And the Bible teaches us this. As He thus spake for Himself, Festus said with a loud voice, Paul, thou art beside thyself, much learning doth make thee mad. But he said, I am not mad, most noble Festus, but speak forth the words of truth and soberness, for the king knoweth of these things, before whom I also speak freely, for I'm persuaded that none of these things are hidden from him, for this thing was not done in the corner. King Agrippa, believest thou the prophets? I know that thou believest. Then Agrippa said unto Paul, O most, thou persuadest me to be a Christian. And Paul said, I would to God that not only thou, but also all that hear me this day, we're both almost and altogether such as I am, except with these bonds. You may be seated. As we look here today, church, we're serving a great and holy God. And we hear we find one of the apostles, Paul. He was on his way. They lied about him, and they brought him up to Festus, and eventually we'll see where he appealed to Rome. But you know what? Today God was in control. Today he's in control of every aspect of our life. So, as we look at this, we see Paul talking to King Festus here, Festus here, about being a Christian, about being converted. And Paul just loved everywhere he'd go. He told about his conversion. And he looked at Festus and he said, did I believe? And Festus said, almost, thou persuadest me. And as we look at this today, church, there are a lot of people that are almost persuaded. I never read where this King Agrippa had another chance. Do you? As far as we know, he died and had been in hell for 2,000 years, got an eternity to go. So, what the king needed most was not money, was not power, was not influence, was not health. He needed Jesus. And today, church, we don't need the things I've already read. What we need is more Jesus. He is the one who's able to help. He is the friend that sticks closer than a brother. He is the one who helps us in the midnight hour when we can't sleep. He is the one that lifts us up. He's the one that takes care of us. It meets our needs according to the riches that he had in glory. As we look at this, I'd like to preach on just a little bit on the friend everybody needs. But the friend everybody needs. I'm glad he is my friend. The question is today, church, is he your friend? Bible says for a man to have friends, he must prove himself to be friendly. And there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother, which is Jesus. And as we look at this, I mean, I'm glad he saved me. I'm glad he keeps me. I'm glad he delivers me. And all these things. But most of all, most of everything, the proudest day of my life wasn't the day my daughter was born, but that was a proud day. It wasn't the day me and my wife got married. That was a proud day. The proudest day I ever had was the day that I accepted Christ as Lord and Savior. What did I get today, church? I had forgiveness for my sins. I had no longer had a destination of hell, but I had a destination of heaven. Not only did it make me born again, but it made me a better husband and eventually a better father. See, today, church, Christ changes everything. When we were growing up, we always told our children, be careful of the friends you choose. You know, we don't want you making them, let's just face it, we just look at them and say, we don't want you hanging out with that hoodlum over there. We don't want you hanging out with that little drug addict over there. Make better choices. Make better friends. Something's going to encourage you, not bring you down. Jesus is that friend that encourages you, that doesn't bring you down, that lifts you up as you go. Today, church, we can go to great heights with Jesus as our friend. Without him, we'll fall to great depths. But aren't you glad he is our friend? Today, church, as much as I love my wife, she can't stay up all night with me and help comfort me, but Jesus can. There's a lot of things my family can't do, my friends can't do, but Jesus can. That's why he is our friend. What does everybody need from Jesus? Have you ever thought about that? And we look at this, there are three reasons we need Jesus. Because of our past, because of our present, and because of our future. Now think about that today. And I'll break it down, Lord willing, into bite-sized pieces. But as we look at this, we need Jesus because of our past. Because I have in the past, we have sinned. Now think about that. We all sin and come short of the glory of God. Now, what were we before we were born again? We were sinners. What are we now? We are sinners saved by grace. Today, church, on my best day, the Bible teaches us that my righteousness is as filthy rags before the sight of God. So what do I need to do? I need to talk to this friend who cleans me up, who takes away my sin and covers it with his red blood all over again. Bible says anything's not of faith is sin. Did you have a bad thought coming to church this morning? That's a sin. But God forgives us of our sin if we'll ask. Right? Mm-hmm. I don't want anything lingering behind me. I want everything under the blood. When I leave this walk of life, I want to make sure everything's under the blood. Don't you? I mean, I know I'll go to heaven without a shadow of a doubt, but I want to make sure there's no speed bumps along the way. And glory to God, with Jesus as a friend, there is no speed bump along the way. I believe this, that if we would just walk with him here on earth, he'll walk us to the other side, hand in hand, in peace with him. See, today, church is, you know, we have our sinful words, we have our sinful thoughts, but praise be to God, there is a fountain filled with blood. And this the old song says, there is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunged beneath that flood lose all their guilty stains. And today, church, I've been cleansed. And so have you, if you know this friend. See, this is what it means to be a child of God, is that our sins are forgiven us, not for any great thing that we have done, but for what Christ has done for us. What has he done? He died, he arose, he shed his blood, that we can have life and have it more, what? More abundantly. That's what he wants us to have, is an abundance life in him. We have life. When we go over there, we'll have eternal life. But today, church, my life in Jesus is the best it's ever been. The worst day I have as a Christian is better than the best day I have as a sinner. Mm-hmm. And today, church, he said, preacher, you shouldn't say it that way. But we've all had bad days. Amen? Right. We've all been run through the ringer. Yeah. And when we run through the ringer, what do? We go to that friend. He entangles us. He fluffs us up. And glory to God, he loves us. That's what it's all about. It's about love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And see, today, church, this is a great part about it, is that when we leave this walks of life, every sin that we have written in black ink has been made red. My name is written with his precious blood in the Lamb's book of life. And glory to God, when it comes down to it, And I shared this with you a lot of times, church. I'm glad today that when he sees me, he doesn't see me. He sees the blood of Jesus over my life. He don't see the sin. He sees the love. That Jesus, my friend, my Lord, my Savior, my advocate, upon that day, will say, he's one of mine. Enter in. Isn't that what we all want to hear? But yet people are turning away this marvelous gift of salvation. They're turned away, a way of eternal life. For what? A few fleeting things in this world? It's not worth it. You think, well, my friends are worth it. No, they're not. My money is worth it. No, it's not. Oh, my job is worth it. No, it's not. There is not one thing worth that is worse than not knowing Jesus. If you don't know him, all the friend, all the money, all the jobs will lead you straight to a devil's hell. But this friend Jesus will lead you upward. So, I like that verse, and you've heard me quoted a lot of times over there in Matthew 11, chapter 28, verse. Come to me, all ye, whoever, all ye who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
That's right.
I need rest, don't you? We struggle in this life. We struggle physically. We struggle emotionally. We struggle spiritually. And we need that rest. And I found rest in the arms of Jesus. In the past, what have we seen? I need Jesus because of my past, because of the blessings he has bestowed upon me. In today's church, as we look at that, Ezekiel said his mercies is new every morning, are new every morning. See, today, church, we can't outgive God.
Nope.
I mean, think about it. Where would you be without the mercies of God? Where would you be without the blessings of God? We would be ruined. But aren't you glad today that the mercies of God are new every day? Every day we wake up, we feel his loving arms around us. Every day when we wake up, we feel his Holy Spirit within us, leading, guiding, directing, telling us everything's going to be all right. Then we need him because of our past memories. There's loved ones that have gone on before that I want to see.
Yes.
Amen. As I shared with you last week, there's a little song that says, I've never been this homesick before.
Amen.
And I haven't. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to get a bus load up and ready to go. If the Lord would bless us to go that way, I'm ready to go to cloud of glory. But I'll take a bus. In today's church, we might go by the grave, but that's all right. As long as Jesus is with us, that's what matters.
Mm-hmm.
He is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And everybody needs this friend. You know, a lot of times people say, well, I need this friend because of the contacts I can make. I can grow my business. I can do this. Why are people so busy laying up their self treasures here on earth for moth and rust that doesn't corrupt?
That's right.
But rather not. Why not lay up their self treasure in heaven where the seeds don't break in, the moth and rust do not corrupt? See, today, church, as we look at this and we look at the memories, we look at our past, we look at everything about us, it's fleeting. But there is a hope that when we leave, and remember, hope in the Bible is not, I wish it was so. Hope is, I know it to be true. And I know it to be true that when I get to heaven, I'll have a glorified body like unto the Son of God. I'll have a crown, I'll have a robe, I'll have some shoes, I'll be up there with Jesus. And today, church, I'm not worried about the mansions. I'm not worried about the walls of jasper and the streets of gold. I'm not worried about any of that. What I want to see is my Lord and my Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to walk hand in hand with him down Heaven Avenue, Jackie on one side, Melanie on the other side, and me in the middle. I don't know how that'll work, but it'll work. It doesn't seem. That's what makes heaven heaven. I need Jesus. I need this friend because of my past. But I need him because of my present. Today, church, Bible teaches us he was, if you ever look at it this way, he was that Christmas present to a lost and dying world. Now take that and switch it just a little bit from present as a gift to present within us always. So we need him for everyday living. Now let's just face it today, church. Life can be a drag, right?
Yeah.
I mean, life can be a drag. There's heartaches, there's troubles, there are trials, there's cares. But there's a friend that sees us through.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you take a look at somebody that doesn't have Christ, they're not living life at its best. They're living below the standard that God has set. But God's people have a standard that he has set for us. I love it when he says, come and dine. Don't you? I don't know about you, but I remember Mom used to get out there on the back porch, yell at us, dinner's ready, or supper's ready. In other words, come to the house, get cleaned up, wash your hands, comb your hair, set your hat on the hat rack, sit down, it's time to eat. And that's the way it's going to be. And I'm going to talk about it. I've already jumped onto the future side of things, but that's all right. But today, church, that's what it's going to be like. I mean, yes, we work hard in the field. That old song said, I'm just an old plowboy working hard in the field. My crop is salvation and the wealth that it yields. Glory to God, aren't you glad today that we're going to lay this old hammer down? We're going to lay this old the body down. And we'll pick up a body like into the glory of God. All the heartaches, troubles, sickness, pain, death is to be gone. That's what my best friend does. I need him for everyday living. I get excited sometimes, mess up this message and stuff, but God knows how to put it together. But you know what today, church? I need him today more than I need yesterday, and I need him tomorrow more than I need him today if the Lord tarries his coming.
Yeah.
And as I look at this, I realize that everything that I'm facing in my life, Jesus has faced it.
Mm-hmm.
He had over there in the garden, he was facing death, but he looked up to heaven and said, nevertheless, my will, thy will be done.
Mm-hmm.
It leaves us an example. We look and over there on the cross where he said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. But I look at that first Easter morn when he walked out in his love for a lost and dying world. Today, church, that's why I need him today. I need him to help him overcome this temptation in this world. And we need a comforter in this present time.
Yeah.
As I've already said, this world does pretty well, drags us down. But you know what a good friend does for you? They lift you up when you're down. They comfort you. And this is Jesus. Today, church, if you want an example of what a friend is, you look to Jesus. Because there is no better friend. I need him today because I need an intercessor. When I cry out in pain, my intercessor is there to take it to the Father. When I cry out when I'm in trouble, he's there. When I cry out I need deliverance, he's there. Forever making intercession for you and for me. Today, church, without him, we're nothing. Without him, we don't have a way to the Father. But through him, we do. I'm almost done. We need Jesus because of our future.
Amen.
In today's church, in the future, there is death. I mean, It's appointed unto man to once to die, and after this to judgment, what Scripture says. But we have this life we have around us that's surrounded by death. But we go from, when we're born again, we don't go from life to death. We go from life to life. Because this old body will lay down, but glory to God, our soul's going to live forever, either in heaven or hell. And I choose heaven. That's what I'm. That's my choice. That's my prerogative. That I can choose Him, and I did. So I'm going to heaven, and so are you if you've accepted Christ as Lord and Savior. But today, church, what we need to do then is we look at this intercessor and or this death. I mean, death is a great unknown. Mm-hmm. I've never faced it. You've never faced it. But it looms upon us. But I've learned not to look at the death, but look at the life in Jesus Christ. Because then we have life and have it more abundantly. I heard Brother Lester Roloff one time, just on a CD I had in my truck, saying he just looks like he looks to death as an old friend. That he just looks to death as somebody that's going to take him from here to glory in hand. And today, church, I hope and pray I'm that brave when it comes my time to go. But I have a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And I'm glad today, church, he's my advocate. I'm glad that he's my friend in judgment. Now think about that. Unto man wants to die, and after this to judgment. If you have this friend, you know where you're going. You're going to heaven. There's no ifs, ands, or buts, but that's where you'll be. And think about it. Today, church is heaven, but nothing but a rock pile with a bunch of lizards on it. I want to go because Jesus is there. That's where I want to be. And that's where a lost and dying world could be, too, if they just humbly accept Christ today. And as I've already said, I need Him in my future because of eternity. And today, church, just as long as it is, eternity in heaven is long. That's how long eternity is for those that don't accept Him. I wonder today, church, what do you need? Who is your best friend? If you got somebody you highly esteem above Jesus, Jesus is not your best friend. But I would urge you to change friends today. If you'll rise to your feet and give us a verse of a song, please. Today, church, how is it with you? Have you talked to this best friend lately? Have you left everything with him? I'm glad today, church. And my recommendation don't mean much in this world, but I tell you what, when I recommend Jesus, I'm recommending the very best.
Amen.
Grade AAA plus. Could you come today if you have troubles, trials, worries, or cares? Could you come right now? Do you have a need? Could you come?
A friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear, one privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. We often forget what needless pain we bear.